Hello, welcome back. I'm Katja. Today we're going to do a little Pilates sequence that will focus on our core, on our tummy, on our side and also on our back. This will take probably about 20 to 25 minutes, so I hope you can fit that in into your busy day. Let's begin. Come and sit. Stretch your legs out in front of you. We'll have our feet, knees and hips all in line with each other. And then take hold of the back of your legs, sitting up nice and tall. Close your eyes for a moment. Let's take a nice deep breath in and a soft exhale out through the mouth. Inhaling, feeling your sit bones rooting down. And as you exhale, feel the spine growing up tall with your shoulders releasing down. One more inhale and a nice long exhale. Inhale again. Now as we exhale, we start to draw the abdominals back and curl into our lower back, creating a C curve with our spine. Inhale, roll yourself forwards, reach up through the crown of the head. Exhale, curl gently back again. For now, use your arms to hold on to your legs to give yourself a little bit of support. Inhale, come all the way up again. And exhale, curling back. Staying in your C curve, place your right hand around the outside of your left leg. Hold onto your leg, turn your chest, and feel your left side drawing in to the center of your body, feeling your obliques working. Inhale, come back through the center. Exhale, we'll go over to the other side. Now you'll feel your right side working. Inhale, center. Let's repeat again. Hold onto your leg. Keep scooping the tailbone under. Inhale. And exhale, switch. Inhale, bring yourself back to the center. Hold onto both legs. And exhale, come forwards. Bring your head towards your knees. Allow your spine to round and over your legs. And we roll ourselves all the way back up. Inhale, sit up nice and tall. Exhale, curl back down again. Now this time we keep holding on to our right leg with our right hand. Stretch your left arm forwards. Inhale here. Exhale, make a fist and pretend you're pulling on a strap or spring or band that you're pulling back. Inhale, reach forwards. Exhale, draw the elbow back. Turn your chest to your left. Inhale. Exhale, pulling back. Inhale, come forwards and take hold of your leg. Second side. Inhale, reach the right hand forwards. Exhale, draw the elbow back. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale and exhale. Reach forwards, hold onto your leg. And slowly come all the way back over your sit bones, round on your spine towards your legs, and sit yourself up nice and tall. Take your hands a big step behind you, stretch your legs out, and let's give the front body a little release by lengthening, lifting the chest, relax your tummy, allow your ribs to open. One more inhale here, and exhale. Good. Bring yourself forwards again. Sit back up again. Bend your legs. Inhale. Nice and tall. Shoulders drawing down. Exhale. Curling back again. Okay. Now you can keep holding onto your legs if you need that little bit of extra support. Or you can stretch your arms out forwards. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left arm first. Pull the left elbow back. Inhale. Reach forwards. Exhale, second side, draw back. Breathe in. You can create a little resistance. Inhale. One elbow pulls back, the other arm reaches forwards. And switch. And switch. Reach the arms forwards, hands around the back of the legs. Scoop the tailbone forwards, come back even more to your C curve, and then slowly come forwards, round and over your legs, and then roll yourself all the way back up. This time take your hands back with your fingertips pointing forwards or to the sides. From here, push the floor away, scoop the tailbone under, lift your hips up. Press your feet into the floor, use your butt to lift your hips up nice and high. Lift out of your shoulders and breathe here. Feel the work in the back of the legs as well as in your glutes, your bum muscles, and of course your arms and shoulders. Slowly lower your hips all the way back down. You can stretch your legs out, reach your arms in front of you, and let's slowly roll ourselves down onto our backs. Use your tummy. If you need to support yourselves, bring your hands down to the floor. Roll all the way down. Give yourself a nice big stretch. Take your arms all the way back. And then sweep the arms all the way around and down. Bending your legs. Placing your feet again in line with your hip joints and your knees pointing straight ahead in line with your toes. Stretch your arms forward. So I'm going to move my ponytail a little bit so that I can keep the back of the neck nice and long. If you find that your head is tipping back, you may want to place a cushion or blanket under your head just to have a little bit of support. Stretch your arms forwards. Breathe in. Breathe out. We start with our abdominals, draw the abdominals down, tilt the pelvis backwards, rolling slowly up through the spine, pressing into your feet. If you can, make a straight line from your shoulders to your knees. Inhale, and then exhale, roll slowly down, starting from the top of your back, the middle back, the lower back, and then your pelvis with the tailbone. Inhale, release to neutral. Exhale again, abdominals drawing in, scoop the tail under, roll slowly up again. Feel the knees reaching out forwards in line with your toes. You feel your hamstrings and your bum, your glutes really strong, helping you to stay up there. Inhale. Exhale, roll slowly back down. Inhale at the bottom. Exhale, we roll up again and we add a little arm movement. Roll slowly up. Inhale, stretch your arms up towards the sky. Exhale, pause the arms, roll slowly down. Focus on the articulation of your spine, peeling down piece by piece. Inhale, take your arms all the way back. Be mindful not to arch your lower back here. Exhale, big circle with the arms all the way around and down. Stretch the fingertips forwards. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, roll up again. Vertebrae by vertebrae, slowly rolling up, pressing into both feet nice and evenly. Inhale, arms up to the sky. Exhale, peel slowly down. Abdominals drawing in tight. Inhale, reach your arms back. Exhale, circle the arms round and down. One more of the same. Inhale. Exhale. Using your abdominals, your hamstrings, your glutes. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, roll slowly down, lengthen the tailbone forwards to your heels, stretch your arms back, and sweep the arms around and down. Breathe in, breathe out, roll up, keeping your arms on the floor. Breathe in here, shift the weight a little bit more to your left leg, and then pick up your right leg, float your right knee in. Now see if you can stay nice and strong on that left side holding you up. Tap the right toes down and bring the leg back up. Tap it down and bring it up. The whole time you're keeping your hips up, you're trying to lift the tailbone nice and high so you're not taking any strain into your lower back. Lift and tap and lift. We'll place our foot all the way down to the floor. Even out the weight for a moment, feel nice and square. Inhale, take your arms up to the sky. Exhale, roll slowly down, draw the tailbone forwards to the ears, reach your arms back. And circle the arms around and down. Inhale, preparing for our second side. Exhale, curling up again. We're standing now on our right leg, making sure the right knee points forwards in line with the toes. Float your left leg up, tabletop position. Let's do 5 toe taps. Tap down and lift the leg up. Tap and lift. Tap and lift. Tap and lift. Tap and lift. Place your foot all the way back down. Even the weight out through both of your feet, your legs. Reach your arms up to the sky. Roll slowly down. Stretch your arms all the way back. We'll open our arms out to the side and place our arms into a T shape. So hands are just a little below your shoulders, palms up to the ceiling. Closing your feet, your knees, your legs, squeezing them together as if it's one big leg. Inhale. Exhale, tip your knees over towards the right side. Your left foot is stacked on top of your right foot. The knees are squeezed together. Your left hip has come off the floor and so is your waist off the floor. Keep your shoulder blade on the floor. Inhale. Exhale, use your abdominals to bring your hips back to the center and tip your knees over to the other side. Inhaling here. Exhale, from the center of your body, draw the hips, the legs back and over to the right. Inhale. Exhale, center. If it's comfortable on your neck, you can turn your head the opposite way. Inhale here. Exhale, center. It's a lovely rotation for the lower spine. Breathe in. And one last one to the other side. Breathe in. And breathe out. Come back to the center. Bring the arms all the way down beside you. Inhale. Exhale, let's float up your right leg. You can hold it with your right hand. Breathe in. And breathe out, float up your left leg. Hug the knees in. Let's steer our knees and draw beautiful circles using your arms and your hands to do this. Relax inside the hip joints. Relax in your inner thighs. Change direction, going the other way. And then bringing your legs back together into tabletop position. So aligning your knees over your hips and your feet in line with your knees. Now your lower back will be a little bit flatter on the mat than when your feet are on the floor. Keep it like this. There's no need to force it down anymore. But also you want to be mindful not to let your back arch. So just keeping it where it goes for you and then stabilizing it there using your tummy muscles. Now let's start with our hands supporting our legs a little bit. Breathe in and then breathe out, letting go of your left leg. Stretch the left leg out and reach the leg forward. Inhale, bring your leg in. Hold it with your hand. Extend the other leg forward. So about 45 degrees. Breathe in. And breathe out. If you find it's pulling on your back, take your leg a little higher. Inhale. Exhale out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Reach. Single leg, stretch legs. Inhale. Exhale out. Now, if all is well, you can bring your hands to the floor and continue just with the leg movement. Try and keep your shoulders relaxed. Keep the back of the neck long, just a little bit tucking the chin down. And we're drawing down through our abdominals. Last two. Good. We'll place the right foot all the way down to the mat and our left foot all the way down to the mat. Good. Just check that your feet are not too close to your body now. Step them a really nice, comfortable position away. Again, the hip distance apart in line with your hip joints. Float the arms out to the side and bring your hands under your head, interlacing your fingers. You create a little cradle for your head to rest in. Float your elbows just so you can see them from the corner of your eyes. Breathe in. Breathe out, draw the abdominals in, keeping the pelvis in neutral, nice and relaxed. Lift the chest and head forwards, gazing forwards towards your knees. Inhale, lower back down. Exhale, lifting forwards. Inhale, lower. Exhale, we'll flatten our abdominals. And as we lift, we'll make sure they don't pop out. Inhale, lower. Exhale, curl. Now this time, inhale, we reach our arms forwards, hold onto the legs, and then use that to lift yourself up a little higher, slide the chest bone a little bit more forwards. Bring your hands back under your head, hold your head. Float up your left leg and twist towards your left leg. Inhale, foot down. Lift up your other leg and twist towards it. Inhale, center, two more, and twist towards it. Breathe in, your hips don't move, exhale. Breathe in, and lower all the way back down. Inhale, let's go again. Exhale, curling forwards. Inhale, arms forwards. If your neck needs a little bit more support, you can bring one hand under your head and use that to help you. Curl forwards. Inhale, we bring both hands behind the head. Exhale, float up the leg, twist towards your leg. Inhale, foot down, and change sides. Breathing in center. Breathe out and twist. Inhale, and exhale, twist. Inhale, center. Rest all the way back down. Breathe in, last round. Exhale, up we go, curl forwards. Inhale, reach forwards, hold onto your legs, your pants, your leggings. Exhale, curl, 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 curl. Inhale, take the arms back behind the head. Lift up leg, rotate your chest towards that leg. Inhale, place your foot down. Hips don't move. Exhale, twist, rotating the ribcage. Inhale. And exhale, rotate. Breathe in. And breathe out, twist. Inhale, lower all the way down. Good, one more tummy exercise. Inhale, exhale, curl the chest and head forwards. Stay in the center now, breathe in here. Breathe out, pick up your left leg and hold it. Bring both hands around your knee. Hug the knee in and lift the chest a little bit higher. Extend the other leg out to 45 degrees. We'll switch our arms, we'll change. And switch. And switch, keep the shoulders down and out, out, drawing in through your center, and switch, and switch, and switch. Hug the knees in, curl yourself up into a little ball, lower your head all the way down, release one leg after the other to the mat. And let's allow our hair to roll a little side to side, just in case there's any tension in the neck. Good. From here, come and lie onto your side. I'm going to face you. We'll stretch our arm and our head. If your shoulder is not comfortable, you can put a cushion or block under your head or blanket. Have your arm out in front of you. We'll have our legs nice and long. If you look down, you can see your feet, so legs are just a tiny bit in front of you. Resting your head down. The other hand is in front of you, or you can rest your arm beside you if you feel very balanced. Now feel the body nice and long and create a little lift to the underneath thigh, so your abdominals, your tummy muscles are still working. We're going to inhale here. Exhale, lift up the top leg. Reach out long through the toes. Inhale, lower your leg back down. Exhale, lengthening the leg out. Inhale, lower. Exhale, reach long. So don't worry about how high your leg is going, but more how long you can make it. Breathe in. And breathe out, reach. Inhale, one more. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower down. Now we're going to squeeze our legs together, pretend it's one big leg, and lift both legs off the floor. And slowly touch down lightly. You can also have your arm beside your body. Lift up and lower down. And lengthen and lift. And lower down. And lengthen and lift. And lower down. Couple more, lift. And lower. And lift. Hold. You're feeling your waist working the side of your core. From here, we're going to do little tiny scissors. Keeping the legs straight. Keeping the body still. Just moving your legs. Little scissor movements. Bring your legs back together. And lower your legs all the way down. Good. Bring yourself up onto your elbow. Bending your legs. Check your alignment. Feet, hips, elbow, all in one beautiful straight line. Now pushing the floor away, your underneath thigh is lifted. It's already working. From here, we're going to inhale, lift the hips up, stretching the top arm and reach it over. Exhale, slowly lower the hips down, touching down lightly. Inhale, up we go again, lift up, reach, reach, reach. Exhale, lower slowly back down. Inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Inhale, up we go, push the floor away. And lower down, last time. Lift up, minding your shoulders, keeping those shoulders down and releasing down. Sit yourself all the way up for our mermaid stretch. If your knees are not happy here, you can stretch your legs out, you can stretch your legs in front of you. Inhale, reaching up through the arm and stretch out the side you have been leaning on. Expanding through the ribs. Breathe in. And breathe out. Inhale, reach up tall. Exhale, release your arm all the way down. Let's do our second side. So stretch your legs out the other way, lying down. Nice, long, straight body with your feet a little bit in front of you. So have a little peek down and see your feet. And now make sure you bring your head back in line with your spine. We can have the other hand to help us a little, to help us with our balance. Or you can stretch your arm long beside your body. We'll inhale, prepare. Exhale, we've got our strong center. Lengthen your leg away. Lift your leg up. Inhale, slowly lower your leg down. Exhale, reach your leg away, nice and long. Inhale, lower down again. And exhale, lengthen and lift. Be mindful of your top shoulder that it stays down. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lengthen and lift. Breathe in down. Breathe out, lift. Inhale, lower, last one. And exhale, lift. Inhale, squeeze your legs together now, and then exhale, try and lift both legs off the floor. Inhale to touch down very lightly, exhale, pick your legs up. Inhale, lower down, exhale, lift. Inhale, lower, exhale, lift. Take care that your legs don't start to go behind your body. Breathe in, and breathe out, lift up. Inhale, exhale, lift up, breathe in, and breathe out, lift, holding your legs up where they are, and going into your little scissor movements, scissoring forwards and backwards, keeping your legs nice and long, try not to bend your knees, holding your body, your torso very steady as you're moving your legs. Bringing your legs back together and place your legs slowly down. Lift yourself up onto your elbow and bending your legs. So making sure your elbow is pretty close to you under your shoulder. Draw your shoulder blade down your rib cage, down your back. The underneath side is lifted. From here we inhale, lift the hips up high, stretch the arm over, and then exhale, slowly lower the hips back down. Inhale, lift up. Now we're working our low waist, and exhale, slowly lower down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, up we go. And slowly down. Here's our last one, and lift up. And lower slowly down. Good, sit yourself up for our merperson, mermaid, merman. Feel free to adjust your leg position so that your knees are comfortable. Stretch out the arm you have been leaning on and stretch all the way up and over. Give that side a really big stretch. Breathe out. Inhale. And exhale. Release the arm all the way down. Good. From here, we turn onto our hands and knees. And just to bring our body back to symmetry after the side work, we're going to do our cat stretch. Hands under your shoulders, knees under your hips. Draw your shoulders down towards your pelvis. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Lift the chest, lift the heart, gaze forwards. Exhale, round on your back, drawing in your abdominals. Inhale, lengthening the spine, rippling through. Exhale, round on your back, creating space through the lower spine. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, round. Inhale, find your beautiful neutral position where you have your natural curves of your spine, your abdominal muscles engaged, bottom ribs are in, and the back of the head is up in line with the spine. Tuck your toes under, breathe in, and breathe out, push the floor away. The toes will get a little bit of a stretch here. Lift your knees a tiny bit off the mat. Inhale, place your knees down. Exhale, drawing through your center. Push the floor away, lift the knees. Inhale, lower. Exhale, pick up the knees. I call this box plank. Like a plank, but with the legs bend, like a box. And lower. One more, and picking up the knees. And lower. Release your toes. Give yourself a stretch in child's pose. You may want to come up onto your fingertips and your wrists get a little release as well. Head between the arms. Breathe in. And breathe out. One more inhale, just releasing. And exhale. Lift yourself forwards again. And this time we'll come onto our elbows. So come down onto your forearms. Elbows are right under your shoulders. You can have your fingers interlaced, or if it's more comfortable for you, can have your hands flat on the mat. From here, step your right foot back, tucking the toes under, and step your left foot back. See if you can bring the tailbone down a little more and create a long straight line from the crown of the head down to the heels. Eyes forwards to your hands. We don't want our head to be hanging down. So try and keep the head in line with the spine. Breathe in here, feeling all the muscles working in the front of your body. And breathe out. We'll lower our knees down to the floor, uncurl your toes, and then slowly roll down thighs, hips, belly. Separate your hands if they were interlaced. And press down to lift up the chest. It'll feel lovely for the front body, getting a lovely little stretch. Good. Look down to your hands again. You can keep your hands as they are or interlace your fingers. We're going to peel away from the floor and come back into our forearm plank. You can keep your knees down or tuck the toes under and straightening your legs. Good. Try and really feel you pushing away from the floor. I'd rather you're a little bit higher than you're hanging down into your lower back. Breathe in here. Breathe out. Knees go down again. Toes uncurl. Peel down thighs, hips, belly. Press back into your palms and lift up one more time into a beautiful Sphinx pose. Waking up our back. And here's our last one. Look again to your hands. Coming back up into your forearm plank with your knees on the mat or with your legs straight. Feeling your abdominals strong, your legs are helping. And of course, we're strengthening our arms and shoulders. Knees coming down, peel all the way back down. And this time, let the arms slide out to the side. Rest your forehead all the way down. And rock your hips a little bit side to side just to ease out your lower back. Inhaling, prepare. Now let's do a little bit more work for upper back. We exhale, draw the shoulders down. Reach the crown of the head forwards. And then with the help of your arms, lift up the chest and the head. Inhale, pause here. Exhale, lower down. Still finding even more length in the spine as you come down. Lengthen your tailbone to the heels just to make sure there's no compression in your lower back. Inhale, exhale again, shoulders back and down, reach forward, lifting up. Inhale here, exhale, lower slowly back down. Breathing in, breathe out. Make sure our shoulders are moving down the ribcage. We can use our hands. As long as our shoulders are down, we can maybe even come up a little higher if that feels good. And then we lower all the way back down. One more to go. Draw the shoulders down, reach forwards and lifting up. And slowly lower yourself all the way back down. Slide the hands next to your chest. Push yourself up onto your hands and knees. And again, come back into child's pose. This time have your arms really relaxed. Just let the elbows rest to the floor. Just allow your back to soften, to release. Good. Inhale, lift yourself forwards onto your hands and knees. We're going to tuck our toes under, walk our hands back to the knees, and transition onto our feet, hanging forwards. You can have your legs bend or your legs straight. Release your head. Nod your head a little bit to make sure your neck is nice and easy. And then roll yourself slowly all the way up to standing with good awareness of your abdominals. Good. And from here, let's sweep our arms all the way up to the sky. Stretch up nice and tall. And burst the arms open. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, release. Breathe in, arms up high. Release the arms down. And we'll finish with some elbow circles just to make sure there's no unnecessary tension in our shoulders. Release your arms down beside you. Stand nice and tall and hopefully feel that little bit of more inner lift so you can really go out there and go about your day. Thank you very much for joining me today and practicing.